Thanks for joining us on another year of the Masters Report. Andy was wearing the Taco Bell belt today.
Yep.
Which is one of his sponsors. He says if he wins Washington Road Taco Bell, I've been saying it too much. That's not where he's going to go. He's going to go to a different Taco Bell location now if he wins. No beautiful colors of Augusta National here. Nope. That's my brother Matt scraping ice off his rear windshield Tuesday morning before work in my home state of Minnesota. That is springtime in the Midwest at its finest. I shudder just looking at that. That looks awful.
Horrid.
So if you haven't been appreciating the perfect springtime weather enough, there you go. But I show you that as we head into a par 3 Masters Wednesday with potentially stormy weather on the way. And I just want us all to maintain a little perspective. If it's not perfect, you could be scraping ice off your car like my brother Matt. A major moment for Augusta National and Chairman Fred Ridley with the news of a woman's amateur championship to be held at Augusta National Golf Club starting next Masters. Well, thanks for joining us on the eve of the Masters tournament. I'm Nathan Palm with Zach Hughes, and it's been one of the more eventful Masters weeks leading up to tournament play. The day included what Jack Nicklaus called his favorite golf moment of his life. What a moment for Jack and his grandson. Certainly has the clutch gene of his grandfather.
You get one shot. Put it in the hole.
One shot all day.
That's awesome.
Puts it in. First hole in one of his life, too.
Yeah, on that stage.
Unbelievable. What a scene Tuesday at the back of Augusta National Golf Club, where one of the best Masters traditions takes place. Golfers attempting to skip their ball across the pond on the 16th hole and onto the green. First attempt from Canadian Adam Hadwin, not so great, so he gave it another try. This one, looking pretty good, gets it up onto the green, but the unforgiving green sends it back into the water. No matter, it's early in the week. Stay with us as we walk you through this Tuesday edition of the Masters Report. Tiger Woods plays in his first Masters in over 1,000 days, rebounding with a couple late birdies to finish just one over par. But he's chasing a man quickly, building a legacy of his own at Augusta National. Well, and he also finished the par 3 contest. He still had a couple holes to go, and Scott Van Pelt was asking him, and he was like, yeah, I wanted to see if I could still hit off of it.
That's crazy. Testing it
into the next day. So maybe part of that is one of those where you're like, you're so embarrassed by what happened. You're just like, I'm not going to show the pain. I'm good. I'm going to play through. And he played well. He is in second place. We'll see if he can keep it up. Well, thank you for joining us again on the Masters Report. I'm Nathan Palm with Zach Hughes. And I've got to admit, last night I didn't think that we would be saying tonight that Jordan Spieth was able to stay five shots behind leader Patrick Reed. As for leader Patrick Reed, he says, quote, I am from Texas. The wind blows 40 miles per hour and rains every day, it seems like. Gosh, that sounds pretty miserable. I don't know if it's always that bad. He says, I'd say I like it when it's challenging. So he's not backing off from the weather either. One final note before we go. It was the final Masters for 1998 champion Mark O'Meara. He said after his round that this was going to be it. Sometimes guys say it beforehand.
Yeah.
This time O'Meara saying after his round that was it. One of the more dramatic Masters wins with his winning putt back in 1998. Rory McIlroy joins Patrick Reed in the final pairing Sunday at the Masters. Patrick Reed won two Division I national championships in 2010 and 2011 during his college days at Augusta State. And now, less than 5 miles from ASU's home course, Forest Hills, Reed is leading the Masters, just one round away from slipping on the green jacket. The way that I described it too is like normally when you're, you know, even a birdie, it's like you get a good clap, a good cheer, but this was like people are legitimately screaming and high-fiving like they're at a football game for 5 minutes, and it's like, okay. Like, we got to settle down. It's interesting how convoluted the Patrick Reed storyline is, but if you got to give him credit for one thing, he's ambivalent about it, really. He's like, whatever, I go out and I play golf, and I think he really does not care, and if anything, he might feed a little bit off of some of the hate that he gets. Patrick Reed wins golf's most treasured prize, the green jacket. But it came down to the final putt Sunday. Another awesome Masters week. It's funny seeing those recaps, and you forget, oh yeah, that's right, Jordan Spieth made that charge, but he was leading after day one.
I know, exactly.
He was right there. Well, it was a blast. We enjoyed bringing it all to you. Another Masters week in the books. Patrick Reed, the former Augusta State golfer, your 2018 Masters champion.